It's another big day on the WGN Morning News at 9. Today, a good show with a simple concept. Share a meal with an interesting person at her favorite restaurant. We'll talk to Kate Sullivan about who she's eating with on To Dine For. Plus, Botanic Backyard don't care about no winter. We're plowing through with tips to plan for spring planting. And Larry's up for the list. He's celebrating Peculiar People Day. Live from the WGN studios, this is the WGN Morning News at 9.
Hey, good morning, Mike.
Morning,
good
Jimmy.
Good morning, you guys. I've got Dean with us because we have Disc Jockey Day this week. Yep. And if you remember last year, we had Dean show us how to hit the post on a particular song.
Yeah.
Talk up the record, right before.
Up to where they sing, right?
Right up to the vocals. So to refresh your memory, we're going to have Dean do one for us. And then I want to test a couple of you up there. So,
okay.
Yeah, that's
all right,
fun.
So
okay.
Let's go. Here's the first song. This is Time After Time by Cyndi Lauper.
Okay, let's go.
All right, coming up later on this hour, we've got Kate Sullivan who's going to talk about dining. Larry has a list coming up about peculiar people and an extra special, sexy botanic backyard coming up in just a few.
Wow!
You didn't introduce the song, though.
It's okay.
It's implied.
That's a rookie mistake,
that's
right?
Great.
All right. So now I want to turn to you guys, and Pat, you DJed for a long time.
Yeah.
Right?
I was a wedding DJ, but much more prestigious. I hit the post.
Yeah. You were a post hitter at the weddings and stuff?
Yeah, occasionally.
All right, we're going to challenge you here, okay?
All right.
All right, ready? Here's Pat's song. It's Cashmere by Led Zeppelin. Go.
Hey, come on at you on WGN Radio. We're rocking and socking, booting and scooting. Hit taking and shot making, it's Led Zeppelin, everybody, with Cashmere on WGN.
Especially like the booting and scooting.
I like the mocking DJ voice.
Right?
Yeah, man. I like that.
Okay, we got another one. Robin, you were in radio before you were in television.
Yeah.
Now we've got one for you. I know this in your wheelhouse. This is Walk Like an Egyptian by the Bengals.
Ooh.
Okay, here we go.
Ooh, everybody loves the Bengals. Did you ever wear Bengal bracelets? Oh, they're fabulous. I love them. I wear them all the time. Anyway, this is a great band. This is a great song. Bengals, Walk Like an Egyptian. Here we go.
Wow.
Not quite.
Does this song have like the same amount of time that you can talk to before it starts?
No, it's all different.
Well, depending on the song you chose.
So you got to know the song.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, that was a little. I think I could have done that.
They were trying to get me to do Papa Was a Rolling Stone, which has a 1:31 second.
Okay.
So maybe next year we'll
do that. Okay.
You're like 30 seconds in. So when I was in sixth grade, my parents moved to the song's name.
That's awesome. Awesome.
Yeah, that's
thanks,
great.
Thanks, Doobie.
All right, you bet.
We watch your new show because it's very sublime. I'm so excited because it really is time for 9 at 9. 9-9-9-9-9. So tell us what's new. Now let me throw you a cue. It's 9 at 9.
All right, number 9, if you're dating someone right now and you're not sure if they're the one for you, all you need to do is ask yourself one question. If this was my son and I was his mother and I raised him, would I be proud of him and his character? And I guess the reverse is true if you're, for a man and a woman. If the answer is no, dump him. It's that simple. This relationship advice comes from a woman named Isabella Duffy of Miami. She posted about it on TikTok and went viral after suggesting that women pretend for a moment that their potential suitor is their son. Her post is getting all sorts of reaction and prompted other deal breakers like, would I let him watch my dog? Would I want him to be the father of my children? Would I want my daughter to date him?
I think that's legit.
Good. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right, number 8. If you're making your homemade spaghetti sauce, there's a pretty good chance that you're ruining your garlic. Overcooked garlic can lead an odd and bitter taste to your sauce, but people often get so worried about overcooking their garlic, they often undercook it, and that can also ruin your dish. So here's the trick. Make sure your oil is piping hot, and then add your garlic. It won't have a chance to glump up, and it will cook quickly. And once it turns golden brown, you're done. Turn the heat way down. Don't let it get any darker than that.
All right.
Larry, have you ever cooked garlic?
No, I can't say I eat it right out of the jar, yeah. Though. It's good stuff.
Yeah, you know your way around the kitchen a little bit more. Robin, you know how to cook garlic?
You've eaten my creations.
Yeah.
No, it's always I follow things to the step, and there's always like a nuance that I'm not picking up on. Like the garlic should not be cooked for 10 minutes straight. They don't tell you exactly what you're supposed to do.
You got to go by some feel.
I know.
Number 7, at Unity Farm Sanctuary, about an hour southwest of Boston, they found a good way to get rid of old Christmas trees, feed them to the goats. We all know that it's better to turn the old Christmas trees into something useful like mulch, and this is even better. The director of the farm says the needles from the trees have great vitamin C and good nutrition. On top of that, it's actually an anti-wormer, and they seem to really like the taste. The farm will feed the goats about 100 trees after Christmas each year.
Look at that.
All right, number 6, you might remember Jared Jeffries for leading Indiana to the NCAA championship game in 2002, winning the Big Ten Player of the Year award, or from his 11-year career in the NBA. So it might be surprising to see him so excited for this.
Oh, if this is a red 7 coming up, you won.
Oh, man.
Because you changed the very last number. Man. Let's see a red 7, please. Yes! What a good win. What a good win to start this show. Way to go.
Yeah, he won a Toyota sedan that it appears he might not even fit into.
Yeah.
He seems pretty pumped for a guy who earned over $30 million playing basketball. He didn't make the showcase showdown, so he didn't get to spin the big wheel, but he seems pretty laid back. Yeah. Walked away from a front office position in the NBA, and these days he seems to focus on hosting a fishing show on the Outdoor Channel. And judging from his Instagram, doting on two adorable dogs.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah. Good for him.
That's great. All right, number 5, high-waisted mom jeans are out.
Oh, no.
Well, just when I started embracing these.
Yeah.
We are now in the midst of an early 2000s revival trend, and it is time once again to pull out the mid or low-rise denim. No, it is not. It cannot work again. Well,
with the half shirt, it works.
It never looked good on anyone.
Yeah.
But they say, go ahead, play with proportion, show a little skin if you feel like it, embrace that tramp stamp that you've been hiding for a few years. Just how low you go is entirely up to you. You don't need to pair with a crop top. You can throw on an oversized sweater or a long T-shirt. But, you know, it's really for the young.
Well.
Because otherwise you're dealing with that. The old muffin top. Remember though? Remember that?
Sure.
Yeah.
It's like there's spillage that happens when you're, you know, it's just, it's...
And sometimes you want to keep the tramp stamp private, right? You don't want to save it for that special someone.
You're right.
But you sometimes want to let it shine also, so to each his own, as we like to say.
You still have yours, Paul?
I do, Matches my mom's.
Yeah. The rose and the thorns, or what is it?
And an anchor.
She has the tribal symbol, right?
Yeah. Well, a lot of things, and then love.
Wow, that's great.
It's awesome. All right, number 4, we're looking at abandoned movie sets like this one, Popeye's Village from the 1980s movie, Popeye movie, starring Robin Williams. They created an entire village and constructed dozens of buildings on the island country of Malta.
Wow.
Once filming was over, it was apparently too expensive to destroy, so the producers just left it there. But you can visit the village if you're ever in Malta. The government turned it into a tourist attraction. Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah, it's kind of cool.
Fun.
All right, number 3, we all know that beekeeping is the fun hobby with sweet rewards, sometimes a beehive can be attacked by invader bees from another hive. It's called beehive robbing, and it's a real problem. So what should you do if your beehive is under attack?
Because first, this is a problem a lot
is.
Of people.
Oh, my Lord, so many people
first,
have been telling me about
this. Use an entrance reducer to minimize the number of bees going in and out of the hive. And another way to combat beehive robbing is by draping a wet bed sheet over the hive. The wet sheet should block off the invaders. News you can use for all you beekeepers out there.
And bedwetters.
Comes in handy. Yeah. All right, number 2, we all know there's been an increase in people acting like jerks on planes over the last few years. But could it be that class sections on planes is playing some sort of a role. The number of unruly passengers worldwide has been increasing for years. The reasons include tight seating, too much drinking, fewer flight attendants, but a study also found the mere presence of a first-class section in a plane mattered. The chance of an air rage incident happening in economy is nearly four times greater when there is a first-class section.
Because there's four times more people in the back section.
That's true. The study author says we all know we live in a class-based society, but it's never quite so in your face when you board an airplane. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah. Oh. And now they've ramped it up because now you have to pay more just to sit in the middle or on an aisle.
That's true.
And so now everybody knows where you stand.
Yeah, that's very true.
Or it's awful.
Yeah.
Thanks, airlines.
Keep up the great work.
All right, number one, widely regarded as one of the best guitar players ever, Jeff Beck passed away at age 78 yesterday. Here is a music video for his song Ambitious from 1985. Which shows off his guitar prowess, and it's also one of those weird artifacts from the 80s with cameos by the most unexpected people.
Paul Jameson.
Ticket number. Have a seat. Name?
Donny Osmond.
What have you done lately?
Well, I used to sing with my brothers, and I sang with this chick named Marie one time, and I'm on my own.
Ticket number, have a seat. Name?
Marilyn McCoo, Cheech, Herb Alpert, and Dr. Joyce Brothers, Beck admits he's not ambitious.
She sits on the other side of the bench. Just ambitious. She's not a bad girl. She's just ambitious.
Hey, Marco, what are you doing here? It's the wrong studio. Old man over there. You told me
back. Oh, yeah.
Just tattoo.
I don't remember this song at all.
Not at all.
Great. Ooh. Great sample.
I don't remember this video. Really?
No.
Hey, Liam, this is really great.
Who else is in this thing? Wow.
Wow.
That's a good guitar.
There we go.
That's a 9 and 9.
It's 9 and 9.